This is Session 10, Audio. Much of what we've already covered also applies to audio. In this movie, we'll look at additional techniques that are specific to working with audio. In fact, audio deserves its own chapter and gets it in Chapter 11. The key thing to keep in mind about Final Cut is that all audio in Final Cut Pro 10 is clip-based. We make changes to clips, not the layers the clips are on. Audio can be either wave or AIF. Preferred sample rates are 48 kHz and 44.1 kHz, and Final Cut converts compressed audio files, such as MP3, into wave for editing. Audio clips can be mono, stereo, or surround, and you can combine all these different formats in the same project. Keep in mind, however, that audio output is either stereo or surround. If you remember only one thing in this movie, remember this. Audio levels must never exceed 0 dB during final export. To do so permanently distorts the audio, and it sounds terrible. We'll monitor audio levels using the audio meters. Now, just as a note, by the way, it's oftentimes true that your levels will exceed 0 dB during editing because you haven't set the levels. As long as this is prior to export, no damage is caused. But during export, during the final share, they must not exceed 0. Audio settings and effects are applied to the clip, not the layer. And the vertical position of audio clips, unlike video, has no bearing on whether you can hear a clip or not. Audio clips, in fact, can even be placed above as well as below the primary storyline, which just seems like heresy to me. So let me show you how to display and adjust the audio meters, how to display audio waveforms in both the timeline and the viewer. I'll explain what reference waveforms are. Show you how to adjust audio clip levels, which is also called volume settings. Show you how to separate audio from video, add fades at the beginning or the end of an audio clip, and how to crossfade between two audio clips. This is a new library and a new project. This is Dr. Vint Cerf talking about the interplanetary internet. And thanks to Dr. Cerf and Alcatel-Lucent for making this footage possible. There's a lot of techniques I've used here that we haven't covered yet, though we are going to get here. Just to call your attention to some of them, each of these clips in the primary storyline is a talking head. And notice how I've used gaps, short gaps, in the primary storyline to improve the spacing and make his different clips sound more natural. This is a connected storyline. It is a collection of clips. Before, we've been working just with single clips. We can group them in a connected storyline. I'll talk about that more in another chapter. When we play this back, take a listen.
In another role that I have at the Jet Propulsion Laboratory, we've been working for the last 6 years or so on the design of an interplanetary extension of the Internet.
Okay, he's talking about the interplanetary Internet, but I just see picture. I don't see audio. How can I see the audio waveforms? It's not visible in the least. Well, we go down to this switch, and we turn on waveforms by clicking on one of these four icons to the left. This icon, where we've been so far, is picture only. This icon is audio only. This is a little bit of picture, 25% picture, 75% sound, 50-50, 25-75. It's just a way of displaying audio waveforms. I tend most of the time to work with this middle one where I can see both the waveforms and the picture. We can also see waveforms up here by clicking on this film strip icon, check show waveforms. We see this one is silent and these two have audio. If you've got eagle vision, you're going to notice ghosted back waveforms. These are called reference waveforms. Sometimes our audio is so soft we can't hear it. And this allows us to see what the audio waveforms would look like if we pulled the audio gain all the way up. I don't need to see audio up here, so I'll turn that off. But I do want to see audio down here. In order for us to measure audio, we need to use the audio meters. That's these itty-bitty, tiny-teeny little things down here, which are...
In another role that I have...
Interesting, but of absolutely no use. We need something bigger. To get bigger audio meters, simply click once on the small ones. This opens up audio meters. Grab the edge of it, and we can drag these over. The left-hand channel and the right-hand channel, that's the zero that we must not go above. and audio is measured in negative numbers going down from zero. The louder the audio, the taller the spike. Watch again, Dr. Cerf.
In another role that I have at the Jet Propulsion Laboratory, we've been working.
Final Cut 10 measures peak audio, the instant by instant loudest your audio has been. There's another way of measuring, which are average sound levels, also used on audio meters but generate different numbers. Everything we talk about in this training will be peak based, not average based. Notice that as we play Dr. Cerf, it's quite quiet, down around minus 20.
For the last 6 years.
Too quiet. Way too quiet. We need to make it louder. So how do we adjust the level? We grab this black horizontal line and drag it up. There we go. It needs to change to a double-headed arrow. Drag it up to make it louder. Drag it down to make it softer. Notice the white numbers in the black box. That shows us how much we're changing the level. As the numbers decrease, go negative, the sound gets softer. As they increase, go to positive numbers, the sound gets louder. But wait a minute, Larry, I hear you saying, wait a minute, you can't do this, my mind just exploded. You've already said that the number one rule is that our audio cannot exceed 0 dB, and yet as soon as you grab the volume and drag it up, we're like plus 12. How can, have you lied to us? And you have a right to be suspicious. There's actually two ways of measuring audio. One is a relative level, and the other is an absolute level. When we are adjusting the black line, we are adjusting the level, the gain, the volume of a clip, relative to the level at which it was recorded. Making it louder will always be a positive number. Making it softer will always be a negative number. We are changing the level compared to the level at which it was recorded. The audio meters show the absolute level of the audio. When it was recorded, it was at negative 20. Now that we've pulled the gain way up to plus 12 and we play it back, it's going to be much louder.
Or so on the design of an interplanetary extension of the internet. We want to standardize the community.
And now it's softer again. Why? Because the gain settings are applied to the clip, not all the clips in the track. So I would adjust the gain by grabbing these and dragging them up. Wait for the two-headed arrow to show up. Otherwise, if it's a single arrow, you're just going to move the position of the clip. That's going to be a little loud. Let's just pull that down. How do we know? Because the little tips of the waveform start to turn yellow going to red, which says, hey, dummy, you're having your audio be a bit too loud. By the way, if you want to move more slowly, hold the command key down while you're dragging. It gears down the audio and allows you to drag more and change the audio less. If you need to be really precise, dragging command up and down is going to make your life a lot easier. Notice here, I've got Dr. Cerf talking. I'm going to just use the scroll wheel on my mouse or the trackpad to move the audio down. Notice that the audio and video are locked together. I want to overlap these clips. So select the two clips where I want the audio to change differently than the video. We're going to create a split edit. Go up to clip and say expand audio video. Keyboard shortcut is Control S. It keeps the audio and video in sync, but now I can adjust the audio separately by overlapping it. Now I'm going to do something egregiously bad because here he's talking on top of himself. Make sure snapping is turned off. Keyboard shortcut is the letter N. And grab this and drag it so we just have his breath overlapping. And you see this dot? That's a fade dot. It allows me to fade up, allows me to fade up on the audio by simply grabbing the fade dot and dragging it back and forth. There we go. So now we've created a split edit where I'm fading out of the first clip and fading into the second clip. And then we can select both those clips again, go back up to clip, collapse audio video, keyboard shortcut is Control S, and the fade is there. It just makes our timeline a little bit neater, and it sounds like this.
Communications terrestrially. But we have now a
little bit hot. We'll hold the command key down, pull that down one more dB.
Terrestrially. But we have now a set of...
I don't ever want my levels going over zero. Now they will when you're editing, that's not a problem. But when you export, they absolutely positively must not go over zero. Audio is an endlessly fascinating subject for me, though many video editors ignore audio at their peril. For me, video shows us what is happening, while audio captures the imagination and captures the heart. Good audio makes bad video believable, and Chapter 11 covers audio in much more detail. This has been an excerpt of our most recent Final Cut Pro 10 training covering workflow and editing. For the complete version of this online training, please visit our store at larryjordan.biz/store. And thanks